Greetings, and welcome again to Save to Serve and Prophesy Again Ministries for another Prophetic Insights, where we analyze current events as they are fulfilling Bible prophecies. Now, what did the world celebrate yesterday, April 22nd, 2019? As you can see, most of you already know, they celebrated Earth Day, April 22nd, 2019. And one of the primary objectives of Earth Day is to bring awareness to the movement to combat climate change. And two of the prominent persons who are pushing to combat climate change are Pope Francis and Greta Thunberg. And just a few days ago, last week, both persons met at the Vatican, wherein Pope Francis endorsed her movement, the Youth Climate Strike Movement. Now, what has Greta Thunberg done since her meeting with Pope Francis at the Vatican? Well, she joined the London protest, that protest also to combat climate change, which is called the Extinction Rebellion. Listen, it says, April 21st, 2019, blue words, we are the ones making a difference. We the people in Extinction Rebellion and the children's school strike for the climate, we are the ones making a difference, Greta Thunberg told cheering crowds. She goes on to say, and we will never stop fighting. We will never stop fighting for this planet, ourselves, our futures, and for the futures of our children and grandchildren. Now, what is the trajectory of the Earth Day movement, the climate change movement? Both movements will lead to the enforcement of a Sunday law with persecution for dissenters, persecution for God's commandment-keeping people, persecution for God's Sabbath-keeping people. It's confirmed in Pope Francis's encyclical to combat climate change, Laudato Si. And one of Satan's primary tools to get people to bow and to worship falsely is to work through music, yea, musicians, as we see in Daniel chapter 3. Now, how many of you remember the Paris Climate Agreement in the year 2015? Who were the ones primarily pushing the world, the nations, the government leaders to sign that Paris Climate Document? At the root of it were the principles and policies of the Vatican, the principles and the policies of Pope Francis. It was a primary prominent musician called Pharrell Williams. Most of you are also aware of this. Live Earth, Road to Paris, 2015. Don't forget this. We're going somewhere else as we see this. Of course, Al Gore was also present. Kevin Wall was also one promulgating this movement. Now, not only does Satan work through music and musicians. Again, please go and read Daniel chapter 3 with Nebuchadnezzar and the Israelites. And the Bible tells us that the people, even Nebuchadnezzar, said, when you shall hear the sound of all types of music, then fall down and worship the golden image which I have set up. And if you don't bow, you'll be thrown into the fiery furnace. Well, praise God. While the majority bowed, the three Hebrew worthies remained faithful to God. Do we have such a connection with God, like those three Hebrew worthies, to stand for God now, when the mark of the beast is enforced, to stand up against the worship of the beast, yea, the worship of the image of the beast that we find in Revelation chapter 13, verse 1 all the way through verse number 18. One other person, not just a musician, but also an actor, an environmentalist. The devil is at work, and such person is Leonardo DiCaprio. Listen what he said. He says right here, after the headline reads, Leonardo DiCaprio pledges $20 million to tackle climate change. He says, we must demand that politicians accept climate science and make bold commitments before it is too late. This is a demand. When I read that, my mind went back to a statement written in the book, The Great Controversy, showing that this statement and such statements from Earth Movement proponents, climate change movement proponents, are about to fulfill that statement in Great Controversy, page 592. Here it is, red words. It says, and even in free America, rulers and legislators, in order to secure public favor, will yield to the popular demand for a law enforcing Sunday observance, liberty of conscience, which has cost so great a sacrifice, will no longer be respected. In the soon coming conflict, we shall see exemplified the prophet's words of Revelation 12 and verse number 17, which says, and the dragon was wroth with the woman and went to make war with the remnant of her seed, which keep the commandments of God and have the testimony of Jesus Christ. Not only music and musicians and actors and environmentalists, but we also see that this person, Leonardo DiCaprio, met with Pope Francis, and he also pledged to join the movement of Pope Francis to combat climate change. Here it is, friends, in bold relief. And what does the Pope say every nation must enforce in order to combat climate change? Sunday worship, which when this becomes the law of the land, it fulfills Revelation 13 and chapter 14, the mark of the beast. Now, friends, let's come current and talk about how Satan is now using music, musicians, and other prominent people to push the climate change movement, which will lead to the enforcement of the mark of the beast, Sunday worship, by law. Take a listen.
To it on this Friday. So Earth Day is Monday, and we've got an early tribute to Mother Nature. Rapper David Byrd, he goes by another name, but we're not gonna say it. He released a new song overnight simply called Earth. The video bringing together an entire galaxy of musical superstars. Justin Bieber as a baboon, Ariana Grande as a zebra, plus Katy Perry, Ed Sheeran, Kevin Hart, Miley Cyrus, Shawn Mendes, Adam Levine, the list goes on and on. Animals.
Known for his comedic brand of hip-hop, has quietly been working over the last 3 years on a massive all-star charity collaboration, which was released this morning. Earth is a song about the desperate need to save the environment before it's too late, and was produced by Benny Blanco and Cashmere. It features the rapper alongside Justin Bieber, Ariana Grande, Halsey, and, well, a list of stars so long, we're just gonna put all their names on screen for a few seconds.
All right, friends, as we can see, the movement is afoot. I'm going to encourage you to read the scriptures. Isaiah chapter 8, verse 7 through verse number 20. Meditate upon that scripture, as well as Luke 21, verse number 25 through verse 27. When we see these movements pushing fear factors, making people feel the spirit of trepidation. We know that we're living in the last days of Earth's history. So here we have the Earth Day movement. As we can see, it's linked to the climate change movement. And both movements are tending to the enforcement of the mark of the beast. Now hear me carefully. I'm going to confirm. The Earth Day movement proponents are now demanding a national legal holiday. The climate change movement proponents are also demanding a weekly national holiday, even Sunday worship, Sunday observance. Take a listen. Are we here, friends? There it is. So friends, look at this statement, Great Controversy, page 590. Read that statement. Let me move on. So now that we understand the Earth Day movement is tending to the mark of the beast, the climate change movement is also moving for the enforcement of the mark of the beast. Here's my question. Should Bible-believing Christians join the Earth Day movement? Should Bible-believing Christians, should Seventh-day Adventists join the Earth Day movement, the climate change movement? I want to hear from you. Send in your comments. Give me your feedback below under this video. Let's continue this conversation. Friends, watch carefully. Why should we not be a part of such movements? In the book, Great Controversy, page 587, should we not be concerned about creation? Friends, the Bible tells us this earth is waxing old like a garment. It's wasting away. But should we not be concerned? Hear what this says. The Great Controversy, page 587, blue words. It says, the leaders of the Sunday movement may advocate reforms which the people need, principles which are in harmony with the Bible. Yet while there is with these a requirement which is contrary to God's law, God's servants cannot unite with them. Nothing can justify them in setting aside the commandments of God for the precepts of men. If you go back and take a look at the picture of this comedian, Little and the Last Word, that comedian, D-I-C-K-Y. If you look at the collage and that graphic, it makes it seem as if he is representing Adam in the Garden of Eden. And we know that God did create the world in 6 days. Then came what on the seventh? The seventh day Sabbath, the day of rest, the day of worship. So as we see the Earth Day movement and the climate change movement saying we must preserve Earth, bring it back to the condition that God can be honored and blessed even the condition of Eden. We know what's coming next, my friends. The demand, the enforcement of a false day of worship, Sunday by law, which would then be officially the mark of the beast. We can't buy, we can't sell, except we keep and worship on Sunday. We can buy, we can't sell, if we're Bible-believing Christians, commandment-keeping people, Sabbath keepers. Should Bible-believing Christians be a part of such movements? Earth Day, climate change. Look at the screen right here. This is a group of Christians, Seventh-day Adventists, who are also proponents of Earth Day and to combat climate change. We have to be careful. You know what came to my mind just a while ago? At the cross of Jesus Christ, there were individuals there who came just as spectators. But as the cry swelled, "Give us Barabbas, crucify Jesus," even those who were somewhat innocent, we are told that they also became party to that cry. "Give us Barabbas, crucify Jesus." And we are told that demons were in the form of men at the cross. And because these so-called innocent people did not want to look as if they were exclusive, they joined in the cry, "Give us Barabbas, crucify Jesus." Barabbas, the counterfeit son of God. Barabbas, Bar, son, Abba, father. The true son of God, Jesus Christ. And Jesus Christ deserves worship. Christ or Barabbas? Sabbath or Sunday, we have to be careful. May I move on? This happened April 21st, 2019, in Ontario, Canada. The conference there, headline, "Countdown to the Earth Day Summit 2019. Knowing what we have just heard and seen in this presentation, and previous ones, should God's people be a part of Earth Day movement? Climate change? Who are the sponsors? From left to right, General Conference of Seventh-day Adventist Church, North American Division of the Seventh-day Adventist Church, Seventh-day Adventist Church in Canada, Ontario Conference of Seventh-day Adventist, and you can see the other sponsors. Let's move on. Take a listen at this video clip from the president of the North American Division regarding the Earth Day Summit that took place in Ontario, Canada, April 21st, 2019, in the same spirit of April 22nd, 2019, Earth Day. Take a listen.
Hi, everyone. On April 21, at the International Center in Mississauga, a great event is going to take place. It's a first-of-a-kind event. It will be the Earth Day Summit, sponsored by the Ontario Conference of Seventh-day Adventists. We are all stewards of the world around us. That is, we have responsibility to take care of what has been given to us on this planet. The Earth Day Summit will explore various aspects of how we can take care of our home on planet Earth, but also how we can hand over to a new generation a world that still is green.
I'm going to replay this video, and this is simply a caveat. It's simply a warning to the president, to the leaders of the conference there in Canada, to the young people in those Seventh-day Adventist Academy who are also a part of Earth Day Celebration, Summit and Conference, April 21st, 2019, to all Seventh-day Adventists worldwide who are a part of this climate change movement. This is an admonition. Don't take this as Andrew Henriquez is about to excoriate and berate our leaders. No. It is an ominous warning for you. If you notice what President Dan Jackson said, we must all be stewards of this earth, care for this earth in the context of Earth Day. We must preserve this earth for the next generation. What does that mean to you? What is the implication of that statement? Well, the rhetoric from the Earth Day proponents, the climate change proponents within God's Seventh-day Adventist Church, by saying preserve earth for the next generation, they are simply saying that this is not the final generation. It's a peace and safety message in the context of preserving earth. It's crying the words of 2 Peter chapter 3, I believe, the scoffers who are saying, my Lord delayeth his coming. But what is Luke 21? Signs in the sun, signs in the moon, signs in the stars, and upon the earth, distress of nations with perplexity. Are we here? The sea and the waves roaring. Are we here? Calamities. Men's hearts failing them for fear. Are we here? And for looking at those things which are coming upon the earth. For the powers of heaven shall be shaken, and then shall they see the sign of the second coming of Jesus Christ. Matthew 24, Matthew's version says, when you shall see all these things coming to pass, Matthew says that this generation shall not pass till all these things be fulfilled.
Hi, everyone. On April 21, at the International Center in Mississauga, a great event is going to take place. It's a first-of-a-kind event. It will be the Earth Day Summit, sponsored by the Ontario Conference of Seventh-day Adventists. We are all stewards of the world around us. That is, we have responsibility to take care of what has been given to us on this planet. The Earth Day Summit will explore various aspects of how we can take care of our home on planet Earth, but also how we can hand over to a new generation a world that still is green.
Listen what Greta Thunberg said, April 21st, 2019, red words, showing you the same spirit from Babylon, from worldlings, have now entered the Seventh-day Adventist Church. Friends, by God's grace, in the name of Jesus Christ, we do not want Trojan horses in our midst, destroying from within. Red words, Greta says, and we will never stop fighting. We will never stop fighting for this planet, ourselves, our futures, and for the futures of our children and grandchildren. They don't believe that this is the final generation. But as Seventh-day Adventists, as Bible-believing Christians, as prophetic students of God's holy word, we know that based on the signs of the times, we are living in the final generation of this earth's history. I'm going to talk about that in an upcoming presentation. Let's move on. The same sentiments from the Antichrist has come into our churches. And the subject is, the theme is unbridled consumerism. That's the last sentence from Seventh-day Adventists in the context of Earth Day and combating climate change. There it is from the Ontario conference just this past weekend. Unbridled consumerism. And what says the Pope of Rome? Not only Pope Francis, but also Pope Benedict the 16th. Unbridled consumerism. There it is, friends. Same language. Pope Francis warns G20 of effect of unbridled consumerism. So much more I could say. Let me close by saying this. The Ontario Conference of Seventh-day Adventists with the NAD and the General Conference, they had this first summit, Earth Day, to combat climate change on April 21st, 2019. Now they're saying it's going to be annual, yearly, that they can give awareness to the world of God's creation. May I ask you a question? Has God given us April 21st or Earth Day to make the world aware of His creation once a year? Talk to me, friends. Send me your feedback. Give me your answer. What has God given to Seventh-day Adventists to give to the world as a reminder of creation? What is that? It's the seventh-day Sabbath, the commandments, the fourth commandment, Exodus 20, verse 8 through verse 11. Verse 11 says, "For in 6 days the Lord made heaven and earth, the sea, and all that in them is, and rested on the seventh day. Wherefore, the Lord blessed the Sabbath day and hallowed it." And this is a part of the first angel's message of Revelation chapter 14, verse 6 and verse 7. "Fear God and give glory to Him, for the hour of His judgment is come, and worship Him that made heaven and earth and the sea and the fountains of waters." Now, maybe they used April 21st, just piggybacking on Earth Day, to evangelize the world. But these sentiments and the rhetoric and the lottery and the prizes that were given out and having young people rehearse, recite the words from Laudato Si shows the wrong spirit did permeate that Earth Day summit. May we be found praying and weeping between the porch and the altar, saying, "Dear God, spear your people, awaken your people, that we may be prepared to receive the latter-in, the full power of the Holy Ghost. Give the loud cry that those in Babylon may get the opportunity to stand with the faithful, to stand with God's commandment-keeping people. If you have been sleeping, it's time to awake. Awake to righteousness. Awake to the signs of the times. Awake to your own spiritual declension. Dear God, convert me, convert your people," should be our cry. Father in heaven, we thank you for your words. Every name mentioned, we pray for their conversion. Save us, we pray. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen.